sign from God that I should go home. Home to Judah. But wouldn't a church travel without a man?
Thank you. God be with you.
God bless you.
Was that young stranger lurking behind you?
Ruth, the mourner, and her son. I have given her permission to leave and gather among the sheep from under the roof. She's been on her feet since the morning without even walking yet.
My daughter, you are welcome to work with the young women who are leading my field. Stay close to them. I have ordered the young man not to bother you. If you get thirsty, they will give you water to drink.
Why are you so kind to me? Why do you notice me at Barney?
What you have done for your mother-in-law since your husband died is well known. I have heard that your own father and mother and your native land have come here and live with people you did not know. May God, under whose wings you have come for refuge, reward you.
Thank you.
my business. Come over here. I have, shall we say, a business proposition for you. The widow Naomi has returned from the land of Moab. She is selling the field that belonged to our kinsman, Elimelech. A very nice piece of land, I say.
Yes. That's
a
nice piece of land.
I can't believe you wouldn't buy it. I'd buy it. You know the laws of Moses.
When a man dies without a son to inherit his name and wealth, his nearest male relative must marry his widow to make things right.
Whoever buys the land like still has to marry his son's widow.
Wherefore, all along we give him neither of land. The both have to stay in a Limelech's family.
You are Limelech's closest relative. You have his claim on his land. If you want it, redeem it now in the presence of these elders. If you don't want to buy it, I will have you extended.